Hi everyone, it's Penny. Penley-Ann's Creation. Calvin's here helping me with the video. I've been having so much fun shopping. Michael's, Hobby Lobby, Premier, Yarns. Just got my box in the mail last night. DBNY, discontinued brand name yarn. Got my confirmation this morning that's being shipped. Hersner's, placed two orders with them. Waiting on that delivery. And Michael's, you guys saw that. Let me take this opportunity to thank all of my subscribers, viewers, people who comment, and give me the thumbs up. I really appreciate that, and it warms my heart. I would like to say thank you to Crystal back a day. She gave me a shout out and her life. And when I get a chance, I'll go over there and tell her thank you. I understand she watches my yarn haul, and she didn't even know whether or not I knew her. I understand that she is huge in the industry, but we just can't assume that everyone know everyone. And I do know who you are. I have made two bags from your tutorials, and I normally, if I'm looking for something to make, I normally go way back, maybe 3 years ago. And I did find this one. I made this bag a couple months ago. And this bag I made, I used Lion Brand comb. This is a discontinued yarn they have at a comb, and they sell at the outlet. I had to make some changes only because I did not use the yarn that you use. So of course, there was some a lot of decreases because the body is huge, is what I wanted, because when I travel in the car, I keep all types of notebooks and maps and receipts for gas and food so I can track the budget. The handle was bought at Joann's for $15. I had a 60% off discount, and I think it was, I'm not sure, 500 and something, one of her tutorials. So you really have to go back. And I made a book bag of hers, and I didn't bring that. So maybe next time I'll bring that. But these were the two items I made of yours. So yes, I do know who you are. And I'm glad you know who I am. Okay, another thing I would like to say, that Crafts by The Rose, she's a steady contributor to my channel, and she asked me to come over to her channel and view some videos. Unfortunately, I have not done that. I apologize. So everyone, can you give me a hand and go over there and watch some of Rose's videos, give us some comments and thumbs up. It's Crafts with an S by The Rose. So my apologies to you about that, Rose. It is on my agenda to do that, and I said I will give you a shout out, and hopefully that some of the subscribers will help me out so we could get some of your memberships numbers up. Let me put this box down, because this is the box I received from Premier. So what I want you to see was my sweater. This is the sweater by Alex Crochet. This is the one that I always make. Got my fluffiness. And this is by Lion Brand Coble. So this is what I use to make this. Yes, they fit me. She goes to a size 5X. I'm fluffy, but not that fluffy. Okay. So I suggest if you want something really simple, a summer top to wear, I suggest you do that video. I know it by heart. I make them constantly. So I really, really love this pattern. Okay, everyone, I have a lot of things to go over. Let's get to the table. Okay, everyone, before I start talking about some of the projects I'm working on are finished and the yarn haul, I just want to go over this new site. It's not a new site for me. I've been aware of Smiley's for 3 years now, so the company name is Smiley's Yarns, and the website is smileysyarn.com. I'll put it in the description. And they used to have a store. Oh my God. I don't know. Bronx, Queens. Oh, I forgot. But anyway, the store is closed now. I've been closed for a couple of years. How I found out about it, me and Calvin was searching for a lot of yarn deals, and if you know, United States used to be a huge manufacturer, and we had so many yarn companies and fabric companies at one time. We still have a lot, but you really have to do some deep researching to find them. So I found a couple of them, and as I can present them with my videos, I will. So a lot of people know about Smiley's. They're huge in New York. So they didn't close down. They just went to internet base. So it is a good company. I think the minimum requirement is $50. And I noticed when I tried to place an order, when I was placing an order just to look at the range of the shipment, it was a flat fee of $12.95. Do they ship international? I don't know. So every month, what they do have is a yarn of the month. And Lion Brand is the yarn of the month for 99 cents. And you have yarn there 59 cents as well. The minimum order here is $50. You'll see right here, they'll say click here for the Smiley's Internet Yarn Sale. Again, the yarn of the month is the Lion Brand, and this is the yarn of the month right there, and they're calling that a super deal at 99 cents. Then right here, you get a free set of three Lion Brand knitting needles, size 10, 13, 15, with any order that has a $15. No, with any order, and this is a $15 retail value. And this offer ends on the 30th of this month. So every month is new things that's being offered. So you're gonna have to make this one of your, try to make this on, put this on one of your to-do lists. The reason why I've been tracking them because I want to know about the warehouse sale. Last year they did have a warehouse sale. If you click the warehouse sale, and it'll show you the sale for 2018, and you can see all the yarn that they have. The current sale, that was on Manhattan. The current sale for 2019, the dates has not been posted. So you have to keep tracking back or get on their email and they'll send you email every day. And I think last year it was in Queens. So I forgot where they was based out of. I know they based in New York. I forgot. They have the Burnett, the Paytons, Lion Brand, Red Heart, Plymouth, Yarn Art. Some of the other ones I can't pronounce. And Cotton. So it's a very good site. A very good site. So if you get a chance, look at that website. And every month, they have yarn there now for 59 cents. Even though it's not their yarn of the month, they do have yarn 59 cents. I was on the site the other day. This email I pulled down was June 8th from Chudy at Smiley's Yarn. So it is a real company. It's a long standard in a community of New York. Unfortunately, they closed down, but it's just online only. Another thing for the folks that's doing the crochet, no, what is stitch along, Mikey Crochet Crowd, the hydrangea was released. I'm thinking Wednesday. No, the 11th. He released it early. So that's up there. I don't have a picture. Didn't print a picture. I only needed to print 2 pages because I already have the rest of it. I'm not going to be doing this one. I'm only going to be doing the 2 flowers that I've shown you already. Moving along. This was something I found the other day. This is Red Heart Beachy Cover Up. Let me see what size. This go all the way up to triple XL, XXXL. So this is absolutely very pretty. They classifying that as easy. I looked over it. It's can be worked out. It's not that complicated. And if you run into any trouble, I'm quite sure with your expertise now doing crochet alongs, you could be able to fudge it. Here go the piece right here in the belt. Not that complicated. You probably can look at the diagram and work it without even reading it. Quite sure you'd have. Because I've seen so many of these panels and so many other things. This is a top. What is this called? Hello Yellow crochet top. This is Yarn Inspiration. I haven't checked to see if this is the video. This is classified as easy. It may be a video worked along with it. I didn't check, but I looked over it before I printed it, and it was something that I could handle. I'm still in the easy reading patterns, and sometimes the easy fudges me. And this goes all the way up to a 5X. So it looks like it's just single crochet and double crochet. Yes, that, no, double crochet and half double crochet. That's all it is. And see these sleeves right here? These are the sleeves that I'm wearing on my top. And I put that on myself. That has nothing to do with Alice Crochet. So that's something that everyone can make if they want to. I finished a hat that I had on the loom. I made a mistake the other day in Michael's. I said that can be on a 36 peg loom. Actually, this is a 41 peg loom for an adult size hat. So, see how nice the back is? Really nice crochet. So I do not try on the hats because the hats are for donations, and Calvin sells some of my hats as well. So I don't try on any hats. I wouldn't want nobody to try on the hats that I was buying. So I try to use the head to show the hat. So this came out quite lovely, as it always does. The brim, that's a 2-inch brim. Usually take 18 rounds, and the whole hat itself usually is 23. So that's why I said a scheme of 109 yards is
excellent for making a hat on a loom. You will be left with some yarn, not a lot, but if you want to add a pom-pom to it, you have enough for the pom-pom. The other day when I was in Michael's, the charisma, what is this? Sorbet. I picked up, actually it was on sale for $2, and with the two discounts I received, I paid $140. Not bad, being that Hersner's had that yarn on sale for 50 cents a dollar. So this is the start of the brim here, 2 inches, 18. You can make your brim 1 inch a little bit thicker. It works for me. I have the pattern in my head, so it's easy for me to follow. So I'm almost done, because if you can look at this scheme, it's almost finished. So these hats actually that I'm making now is for my donation for the breast cancer patients at the VA hospital in East Orange, New Jersey. So once I get the quantity made, then I start making my hats for them to be sold. Let's move right along. This next item is the cowl that I was working on. I started. Actually came out really, really nice. Calvin's interested in it, but I haven't made a decision. It's either Calvin or one of the ladies at the VA. So far, the ladies at the VA is winning. But we have to see if I can. This works nice for man colors. So he's losing by 2 points. So we'll see. This was, I remember now. This pattern is from Jada and Stitches. However, I didn't do what Jada suggested in her pattern. Because when I make my cowls, I do not like to make my cowls in one long piece and then sew them up the sides, do a whip stitch. I don't like that. I just like to make my long chain. I did follow the chain suggested, and I just continue to work it around. And it's actually a beautiful stitch. Working in the back stitch, single crochet, and you get this beautiful texture. Really nice. I enjoy working with that pattern. I'll do it again, but I will not sew it up in the back. I will just continue in the round. That's how I was taught many years ago. I know how to keep my chain straight. I know how to keep my beginning chain loose enough where I don't get that slant. So hats off to you, Jada. Very nice pattern. I think she made this last year, that pattern, that cow. It's a bucky cow she made for the winter. And she looked very pretty wearing it. This is the yarn that I used for the cow. What is that? A Doki de Latte? Okay, there you go, right there. So I had, let me see. I probably had about two rolls less at the end. I stopped at the gray because I started with the gray and then I stopped at the gray. So I didn't use the rest of them because I wanted it to match. That's why it doesn't matter if my centers match up, because I normally have to do some cutting on the yarn so I can get it to line up. moving right along, this is the cobble yarn that I use to make this top. I use a lot of different cottons. This is a number 3, 232 yards, and it's white. When I worked with it, it did split on me. I enjoyed it so much, I didn't even care. But I also found out through my reading that the yarn is lightly spun. If you probably can see it up close. So, I'm a Susan Bates lady, and that has a very pointy head to it. So, they suggested when you get a yarn and if it splits on you, to change your head so that the head doesn't be as pointy and cause the yarn to open up. See how that's already open? So when you get something pointy, it's going to really open it up. And I'm going to complain it's a splitting yarn. Well, actually, it's not a splitting yarn. It's I just need to change to maybe a buoyed head, not a buoyed hook. That's not something I can work with. But they do have an inline crochet hook that replicates Susan Bates. However, the head is not that intense. So, next time your yarn splits on you, consider changing the needle. Okay, moving right along. These was two scarves that Calvin and I made. We made it Saturday. We made it Saturday. I made the pink one. And Calvin made the purple one. And this is off the Addy. This is for the ladies again. I got to get my work done. Yeah. So. This is on the Addy machine. Absolutely beautiful. Very nice. And the reason why it's two different colors, because when you take it off, if you're okay with this rolling like that, you don't need to use two different colors. You can just let it roll. But I have to have two different colors because you see the pink stitches right here, the first one. This pen is not working. I usually have a crochet hook or a knit needle. You have to pick these stitches up and just line them up. And it's really simple. The same thing like you're doing a whip stitch. You just make sure they lined up like this. And you just pick up each stitch going across. And you'll have a tailored look. It'll be finished. Really tailored. And then after you get that, then you pull out the purple. Sometimes I can pull out the yarn and reuse it. Sometimes it get caught up and I have to cut it out. And it goes into my animal cracker container. So I just wanted you to see how it comes off the Addy. Other than that, I would have sold it together and had a finished tubule. That's a tubule. So when you make the hats as well on the Addy, that's what it looks like as well. So, I did the pink. And when I say I did the pink, I turned the handle on the Addy and controlled the tension. And the purple Calvin did, I controlled the tension and Calvin just turned the handle. So, anything I have to do, like I said, with the purple as well, is line up the stitches. Line them up, sew them together, and here, you're looking for the purple stitches, not the pink one. The first one that you see, that purple one, you line that up all the way around, and then you whip stitch them together. Little John Yarn, she taught me that technique. They make some fantastic stuff on the Addy. Whoa, they are very good with that. And I have a crank too that I use my drill, so the Addy arm goes very fast and I don't have to shoulder problem. So this is really nice, really pretty. And this yarn we used AC Moore yarn. I'm drawing a blank. Nicole used that, her worsted weight. So that's the next thing I was working on is I'm calling these my soap pads. My soap pads. So the other day I was in the bathroom and I had a new bar soap. And I put it on top of the sink because my soap dish was being used by another bar soap. And the soap kept falling down in the sink. And it was so funny. I was chasing the soap up and down. The soap was just up and down. I pick it up, it slide down. So I said, I know what I'll do for you. So I went in the room, grabbed my comb. Well, this had more in it than this. And it didn't take me a whole comb. I've made washcloth, all kinds of things with it. So it doesn't take that much. So I made these. So basically, I looked at the size on my sink where you have the indents where the soap go. So it can hold where you place your soap at. So I kind of eyed that. And I came up with this size. And it was a chain of 11. And I went in the back bump all the way to the end. And I got 10 stitches. Single crochet. One chain and turn. And I just eyed it. I didn't count any rows, so I just kind of lined them up as I was working on them. And they all came out just excellent. So, put this on your sink. Place that soap in there, and you don't have to chase that soap. And another thing is that your soap shouldn't sit in water because it'll dissipate. Even if you put this in your soap dish, it'll keep your soap dry. So you don't want to have this wet cloth on your soap dish all day. So, and what I noticed with the cloth is that after a while it'll become very suzzy, soapy. So I was able to use this to clean out my sink, my bathroom sink. Perfect. I didn't have to chase for no rag. It was right there. Used it, dried it out, and got a clean one, you know? So every day I use a clean one to keep it nice and clean. And it's perfect if you have kids. You know how kids are with the soap. The dirt is running everywhere. So this would be really nice. It can go in a nice closet in your cabinet and pick them up and wipe them down and keep your soap dry instead of it sitting in the water in the soap dish or not staying on top of the sink itself. I did make some with a chain. I made a couple of them with a chain. So it's a good idea if you do clean them out, you can just hang them. They have, if you have towel in your bathroom like I do, 3M have hooks that you put on your wall and you can just remove them easily. You just pull down the glue adhesive. So maybe consider, I think I went with 12 chains and attached it. So that's something nice. You can hang these. Another thing that I came up with, that if you just fold these in half, they are a perfect size for eye makeup remover. So the astringent that you use on your face as a regimen for your morning and night facial duties. This is a perfect size to remove makeup and eye makeup. This way you don't damage your good washcloths or your face cloth, what you call them. And you can make a ton of these to just get your makeup off. And you know that bag that comes with yarn in it? Or maybe some pantyhose. And when you get enough of them, you spray it down with the laundry stain remover. So when you get to cleaning them, maybe in a set, the makeup will come out easily. So that's an excellent idea. Okay, enough of that. Let's move this to the side. So I made a stack. I'll put some in, how many bathrooms? We have 3 bathrooms, so I'll put a couple of them. And also probably put a couple of them on the kitchen sink as well. This one, Mikey from the Crochet Crowd came out with this, what is he calling this? Footsie blanket. This came out, I think it was Sunday? It came out Sunday. So here go a picture of it. So basically the bottom of it is sewed together once you make it. And this is the part that you stick your legs in. And if you go and watch the little video and he explains why he made it, it's really kind of nice. I don't even know why I'm making it, because I don't like my feet to be encased in anything. But I thought it was something cool, very simple pattern to make. And I am using Bernard blanket. And this is pink. Pixie pink. I'm using this one. And I think this is red. I lost my label. Let me see if I attached it to the back. So I'm using that's called race car red. This is race car red. And this is raspberry ribbon variegated. So I was fortunate that I had these yarns available, and those are actually my favorite colors. So I started that on Sunday, and it took me a couple of hours to get. So this is the top. And bear with me 1 second. If I can hold it up. I have some yarn ends. Okay. So that's the top. The top is getting wider and wider. See, that's the foot area. So as you go up row by row, it gets wider and wider to accommodate your body. If you turn it upside down, it looks like a beautiful kid skirt. Can you see that? That's absolutely beautiful. Yep. So that's coming out really easy. It's a very simple pattern. If you're interested, this is the starting of the opening right here. This is where so when you get to the corner, you don't join anymore. So as you go, as they get taller and taller, that's where you'll see, that's the start of this area. So I finished the first part, now I'm on the second part. So it was fun, it was really fun. And it works up fast, very fast. So it's a single crochet. Hold on 1 second. Single crochet. I think that's it. Am I right? Yeah, so you have single crochet, skip a stitch, something like that. But that's all it is. That's all it is. footsie pocket. Fun, really fun. I did this in one day, Sunday. He released it, and I made it one day. Hopefully it can be get done by the winter. That's the basket. I haven't seen these in a while. Okay, let's get on to the premiere stuff that I ordered. And then I could let you, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your day. For all the men out there, I wish you a lovely Father's Day. I hope that doesn't knock that over. Okay, I'm not going to open up this yarn at all because we are at 30 minutes. So, the Premier Serenity yarn is on sale at Premier Yarn for $2. And I think I ordered every color that they have. I ordered this because this is a chunky. This is going to help me with my donations for the ladies at the VA. It's 109 yards and it's perfect. I love these. And if you have never ordered from Premier Yarns before, check out Cinnamon and Stitches. She has a code on her website. It's a welcome code for the first time orders for Premier. So, and it's 15% off. And she has the code on her site. So if you're a first time order of Premier, you can use the code on the sale items. So here goes some of the colors right here. They were $2. Mm-hmm. So they put them in packs. So I bought every color that they were selling. Yeah, really nice. So these are the packs of yarn. All different kinds of colors. Just grab them. And I make my hats, and I keep it moving. So, if you go on the website, every color I'm showing you, if it's still available, is there. So, I have my yarn for the season. I am extremely happy about that. I'm going to push this box over. Okay, didn't make too much noise. And these are my absolute favorite. These are the Premier Luna, and this is the anti-pulling, 273 yards. So, let's see if I can get a light color. See if I can get a light color to open. They really have these things taped down. Where's the tape? Okay. Show you what the ball looks like. Michaels have a similar yarn as well. And these was also $2. So it was 18 colors. I brought every color. I still have a lot of this from 3 years ago when they first came out. 2 years ago when they first came out. Mm-hmm. Is that my first? Mm-hmm. That's the name, 273 yards. So I brought every color, $2. Really, really nice deal. They have a lot of yarn that's on sale. They reduce the yarn. Hersna is reducing yarn. Michaels is reducing yarn, the whole store. looks like they're getting ready for fall. So these names represent the solar system. That's what they represent. So they have solar names. That's what I noticed about them. So if you can, check Premiere out. And like I said, if you are new to ordering from Premiere, check out Cinnamon and Stitches. She has a 15% discount code. You can use that. Give her a thumbs up when you use the code so she get credit for it. Okay, everyone, thanks for supporting me. Enjoy your day. Enjoy your weekend. Hopefully you have some fun doing Father's Day weekend on Sunday. Me and Calvin's going to cook out tomorrow, Saturday, and cook out enough food for the week so we won't have to cook. Bye!